Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos. Now the next problem is problem 257. So in this problem it is said that the small crane is mounted along the side of a pickup bed and facilitates the handling of heavy loads, right? So this is a small crane, right? So in a pickup bed, and it facilitates to lift the loads. So when the boom elevation angle is theta is equal to 40 degrees, if this theta is equal to 40 degrees, the force in the hydraulic cylinder BC, so this is a hydraulic cylinder, so there is a force, right? And that force is 4.5 kilonewton, right? And this force applied at point C is in the direction from B to C. So in order to lift this, so this the direction of this force will be from B to C, right? So if I draw that direction, so this will be the direction of that force. Let me draw it here. So this will be the direction, right? From B to C. Determine the moment of this 4.5 kilonewton force about the boom pivot point O, right? So we need to determine the moment of this force about this point O, right? So as we can see that this point C is the perpendicular distance of this point C from the this E O arm is 110 mm, right? This is 340. Right, so here I have drawn this free body diagram so you people can see it, right? So this is that A point, then this is this D point, right? So I have named it D point, so I will write D here as well, right? And this is that O point, this is theta, this is BC, right? So this is that arm. So now as we can see that this AD length, so this AD length is equal to this 785 mm, right? So this is that AD, and this DO, so this is DO, right? And this CD, so CD is how much CD is given, this is 110 mm, right? Now we need to find the moment of this force, so let me draw that force as well, right? So this is that force. If I draw it, so this is that force acting along this BC line, right? So this is that force. Now we want to find the moment of this force about this point O, right? So if we resolve this force into its components, right? So let's suppose if I resolve this force into its components, so then one component will be this and the other component will be this, right? So that the line of action of this component will pass through point O, right? So this will be the component. So this means that this component, this vertical component will not produce any moment, so only this component will produce this moment, right? So let's suppose if I call this force to be, let's suppose if I say that this force is F, right, which is 4.5 kilonewton, right? So then this will be F if we know this theta. Let's suppose if this is alpha, right? So if we find this alpha, so then this will be F cos of alpha, right? And then what will be the perpendicular distance, this BO length? So this is BO length, right? So BO length is 360 mm. This is BO. So we know this length as well. Let me write it here. So this is 360 mm. Right, this length is 340 and this length is 785 mm, right? So we need to find this alpha. So once we find this alpha, so then we will be able to find the moment about O, and that will be equal to F cos of alpha and the perpendicular distance. So this is the perpendicular distance, so it will be 360 divided by 1000 in order to find the moment in Newton meters, right? So the only thing left is that to find this alpha, right? But this problem is a little bit tricky, right? So let me complete this triangle. So if we want to find this alpha, so then we need to find, let me write that this is E point, let's suppose. So now this is a BCE triangle, right? So then we need to find this CE length and this BE length. So when we find these two lengths, so then we will apply tan alpha, so then we will find this alpha, right? So now if I draw a rectangle here, let's suppose if I draw a right, so as we can see that this CE length, so we need to find this CE length. So if I put C dash here, right, so this is also C dash. And now let me draw one another, complete this triangle, right? So if I write it here, and let me draw one another triangle this problem is a little bit tricky, right? So I will draw one another. This triangle, right? So let me put here, let's suppose that this point, this intersection point is, let's suppose this is O dash. So now as we can see, we have this triangle D O dash C, we have this triangle D O, and let's suppose I put G here, right? So D O G, right? So we have this triangle and we have this triangle. So we have three triangles. Let me write it here. Triangle BCE, triangle DO dash C, triangle DO small g, right? So we have these three triangles. And we need to find this CE distance. CE length will be equal to BO. Let me write in this manner first, right? And plus C dash O, right? So now if I write, so BO is how much? So it is 360 mm. And C dash O is not directly known, right? So C dash O. So the problem here arises that first we need to find C dash O using these two triangles, right? So this DO length is 340, right? So what will be this DG? So DG. So if I write that this C dash O is equal to DG. So this DG, this is DG length, right? And then if I minus DO dash length, if I minus this much length, so we will get this C dash O, right? So C dash O is DG minus this small length, right? So now if I write, so this will be C dash O, and what is DG length? So this is DG length. This is, so it is the sine component of this 340, right? Using this DOG triangle, right? So it will be 340 sine of theta, and theta is known, right? So theta is 40 degrees. In order to find this DO dash, first we need to decide the angle here, right? So if we see here that, so this DC, this DC line is perpendicular to this line, right? This AO arm, and this line, this DG line is perpendicular to this horizontal line, right? This line. So this means if this is theta, so this is also theta. This angle is also theta. Let me draw it in a large size, right? So this is that DC, and this is also theta, right? So why this is also theta? So the angle is made between these two lines, and if we draw two perpendicular to these two lines at same point, so one perpendicular is this to this horizontal line, and one perpendicular is this. So if this is theta, so this angle is also theta, right? So then I will write minus D O dash length. So if this is 110, so D O dash, if this is theta and this is 110, so this will be the cos component. So we will write 110 cos of 40 degrees, right? So this will give us the C dash O length. So now if we find this CE length, so CE length will be equal to 360 plus this much. So this will be 340 sine of 40 degrees. I am using this equation, right? Minus 110 cos of 40 degrees. So this will give us CE length. Let me calculate it. So CE length comes out to be 494.28, right? So now we know this CE length, which is 494.28, right? So in order to find this alpha, we also need to find this BE length. So now what about BE length? So if I write BE length, so as we can see here, so this is the BE length, which is equal to CC dash, right? So then it will be equal to OG, this OG plus this small length, right? So the plus CO dash. So what is the OG length? So OG is the cos component of 340, right? So I will write 340 cos of 40 degrees. And this is that CO dash, right? So it is the sine component of this 110. So I will write 110 sine of 40 degrees, right? So this will give us BE length. So if I find this, So BE comes out to be 331.46 mm, right? So this is also mm. This is 340 and this is also 340, right? So mm. So now we know this BE length. So to find alpha, we will use tan alpha. So tan alpha will be equal to perpendicular. So this will be CE divided by base. That will be equal to BE. So CE is 494.28. And this is 331.46. So if I apply tan inverse, so tan inverse this thing, right? So we will find alpha. So what is alpha? So alpha comes out to be 56.2 degrees, right? So this is the alpha. Now we know the angle of this force, this given force with the horizontal, right? So now we will use this equation, right? So the moment about O will be equal to F cos of alpha. So F is how much? So F is given. So F is 4.5. Let me write it here. So it is given 4.5 kilonewton. This is given here. So 4.5 kilonewton cos of alpha. So alpha is 56.2 into 0.360, right? So if I multiply this, so we will get the moment about O, right? So MO comes out to be 0.901 kilonewton meter, right? So this is the moment about this point O. And what will be the direction of this moment? So the direction of this moment will be clockwise, right? So I will write clockwise